inside my head. I got books I never ever read. I got secrets in my garden shed. I got a scar where all my urges bled. Got people underneath my bed. I got a place for all my dreams. Swim with me into your blackest eyes. As the chillest towns pass my window, I can see a washed out moon through the fog. And then a voice inside my head breaks the analog. Says, follow me down to the valley below. You know, moonlight is bleeding from out of your soul. I survived against the will, through a twisted. Thank you.
Read something about Porcupine Tree, your band is described as being, or is very often described as being a progressive rock band. Mm. But as far as I know, you're not really too happy with this description.
Well, we try very hard to be unique, and we try to be as ungeneric as we can. And by that I mean that we're not interested in playing a particular genre, being a generic band. We don't want to play death metal, we don't want to play progressive rock, we don't want to play space rock. we want to play Porcupine Tree music. And Porcupine Tree music is kind of a mixture of all of the personalities, all of the things we listen to, and we listen to a lot more music than I think some people, and absorb a lot more different kinds of music into our sound than I think some people give us credit for. It is a mixture. I think very often people tend to dismiss anything that is a kind of mixture, particularly if it's kind of slightly arty or slightly more intellectual, as progressive. Because progressive in itself comes from, I mean, the kind of whole genre of progressive rock came from the early 70s, and it was all about bands fusing different kinds of music. So you had bands like Jethro Tull fusing jazz with rock, and you had bands like Pink Floyd fusing the blues with rock. And it was all about fusing new kinds of music with rock and creating albums as opposed to singles. And that's certainly something you can apply to us. You know, we're kind of fusing everything from ambient music to death metal music into what we hope is a unique kind of sound. So it's kind of a little bit lazy for people to dismiss that as it's progressive rock. We have a lot of progressive rock fans, but we also have a lot of metal kids come to our shows who probably have no interest in progressive rock. And we have a lot of people who just like good songwriting, good pop songs, you know, who respond to that side of what we do. So it's not as, don't get me wrong, I don't loathe the term, and I can kind of understand why it's necessary sometimes, certainly for the media, to categorize music. Otherwise, how do you describe something to someone who hasn't heard it? And it's very hard to describe something that is, in effect, indescribable. I mean, the only way to really understand what we do is to hear it. So in that sense, progressive is as good a label as any other, I guess.
my eyes give me away. You tell me all the things you know. Thank you.
Never stop the car on a drive in the dark. Never look for the truth in your mother's eyes. Never trust the sound of rain upon a river rushing through your ears. Imagine the final sound as a gun. All the smashing windscreen of a car. Did you ever imagine the last thing you'd hear as you're fading out was a song?
hear sound of music drifting in the aisles. Elevated Prozac stretching on for miles. The music of the future will not entertain. It's only meant to repress and neutralize your brain. So get squeezed out, hedges get. Silver pills, engineered to suit you, building cheap thrills. The music of rebellion makes you wanna rage, but it's made by millionaires and it limits what you reach. So get squeezed out, hedges get.
Somewhere that you have to be depressed to write music. Why that?
I don't. The simple answer is I don't know why I am like that, but I am. I find that for me, music is in many ways a kind of cathartic experience or a kind of exorcism of negative aspects of my personality. And most of Porcupine Tree music is quite melancholic and quite dark. And people often say to me, your music is very depressing, very melancholic. Is that what you're like as a person? And the answer is no, I'm not, because all of that really, well, not all of it, but a lot of that does go into my art and my creativity. And I think that allows me to be a happier person, and I'm not like that. And I think people are quite surprised very often when they find I'm not like that. They expect me to be some kind of morose, manic, depressive, you know, very negative individual. And I'm not, I'm quite happy, and I think it's almost as if I have this kind of Jekyll and Hyde thing, and the music represents the dark side and I represent the bright side, the light side. And I don't know why I'm like that. I just am. I guess that's just the way my personality and my creativity tends to function.
I'm not afraid to die. kiss me, God kiss pain.
Achieved a lot of things. You're having one big band, you're having a lot of projects. So what is a challenge for Stephen Wilson in 2005?
Well, the big thing for me now really is to try and get more involved in other media, because I think for many years people have always said to Porcupine Tree, or to me in particular, your music would be great in films, you know, or it would be, why don't you guys do a soundtrack, or your music's very cinematic, or words to that effect. And I think the next thing for us is to try and do some major visual project. And actually the last album, Dead Wing, was based on a film script that I wrote with a friend of mine. So it would be really great for us to try and take that to the next level and try and get the movie made, or try and get something. I mean, you'll see tonight with the show, there's a very strong element of visual media is a big part of the show. The band sometimes are, you know, just playing, and the show becomes all about the projection and the film. So we like that kind of fusion of visuals and the music. And I think the next challenge for me is to actually try and get either to get a soundtrack commission from a director, and I'd love to make a soundtrack for someone like David Lynch or someone like that, or to actually get our own movie project off the ground. Other than that, it's just continuing to, evolve, to keep the music evolving and keep the music developing into new areas and keep it fresh.
We'll be right back. train set and match spied under the blind. Shiny and contoured, the railway winds. And I've heard the sound from my cousin's bed, the hiss of the train at the railway head. Always the summers I slept in away. Pass, I'm kissing you wide. The hissing subsides. I'm in luck. When evening reaches here, you're tying me up. I'm dying of love. It's okay.